Let's enter into today's subject. As you all may be aware, I am continuing the yesterday sutra. As I said yesterday, I will give you today some of the deeper understandings on this mind over matter. Stula swarupa sukshma anvaya artatvatva samyamat bhutajayaha. Basic sacred secret in the sutra is how to feel connected, conquer, go beyond the five elements. Feeling connection, falling in tune. Five elements makes the world. Feeling connection with these elements, let me clearly describe. There is a very beautiful story in the Indian mythology. Once Ganesha and Subramanya, both of them have decided to have a challenge that who will quickly go around the world three times. Subramanya, as you all aware, has his own flight, peacock. He just sat on his peacock, started flying. Crossing the continents, crossing the oceans, hills, once, twice, thrice. He completed and came back. He saw this Ganesha, heavy guy. His vehicle is a rat. But this fellow claims he won the game by going round Shiva and Parvati three times. He says, I won the game. I went round Shiva and Parvati three times. With this rat, what else can be done? Yanayai eliyiluttu kondu pogum adisayam. Tamil, I described the rat is dragging the elephant. What will happen? That much is the capacity. But finally, Ganesha declares, I won the game. I went around the Shiva and Parvati three times. Subramanya asks, how can that be? Very beautifully, Ganesha says, you went round your world, I went round my world. Understand, you went around your world, I went around my world. You went around your world, I went around my world. You need to catch this truth. The world, my world. This is the sacred secret. The world is binary, logical, arithmetic, scientific, universal. My world is emotional, based on faith, beliefs, experiences of individual perceptions. Realization of individual identity's expression in its fullest form. My world is totally different from the world. When my world is completely in tune with the world, you are a Jivan Mukta. When there is no conflict between my world and the world, please understand, people who are always going around the world are caught in agitation, anger, stress, rajas. People who are completely caught in my world sometime can miss the world. Here, Ganesha is successful not just because he was centered on my world, he was centered on my world which was in tune with the world. He was completely experiencing my world, the Ganesha's my world and the world is one and the same. Ganesha's my world and the world has become a solid experience for Ganesha. Understand? Ganesha's my world and the world has become a solid experience for Ganesha. I'll give you a clear picture. How ordinarily people are caught between my world and the world and start preferring between these two, someone. When you start preferring the world, your whole life ends in depression. You are drained in my world. When you start preferring my world, sometime you can lose your balance and get into some fantasies and whims and fancies. My world should expand and grow and completely should be in tune with the world. Ganesha. His my world. And the world. Both are in tune because Mahadeva, Shiva and Devi. Please understand, Shiva and Devi are really the world. And Ganesha also experienced Shiva and Devi as my world. Please understand, they were really cosmos. And he is also experienced them as cosmos. So the my world and the world has fallen in tune as the experience of Ganesha. So he going around Shiva and Devi is literally going around the world. Even though he said he went around my world, in his case, the my world is the world. usually human beings who give preference only for the world become extraordinary materialists but end up in spiritual poverty. Spiritual poverty, depression, utter depression. Same way, people who prefer only my world sometime end up in hallucinations without falling in tune with the world. Understand, the world can't be rejected as you think. Misunderstandings about the world should be rejected. For example, fire is the world. Your fears and misunderstandings about fire should be rejected, not fire itself. You can't reject it. Its existence cannot be denied. Maya is the ideas which are not in tune with the world, but you are carrying about the world, are Maya. Maya is the illusory ideas you carry about the world, not the world itself. When you carry the right idea, when you understand the right ideas about the world, you will realize the world is made of the same stuff in which my world is made. Understand, I am giving a new twist. First statement I am making, the fire, earth, water, air, space itself cannot be denied. Your wrong concept about it is Maya. But when your wrong concepts about it is removed, it loses the identity which you are thinking it is having. One example, the fire. You have fear about fire. That fear is called Maya. But fire itself is not Maya. When the fear is completely lost in you, when you are in tune, suddenly you realize what stuff is a base material for you, same stuff is base material for that. You are in tune already. You can play with it, conquer it, go beyond it. Catch it if you can. It's one of the very, very, very subtlest truths. The discrepancy between my world and the world in ideological level is conflict. Discrepancy between my world and the world in practical level is poverty and failure. The discrepancy between the my world and the world in the emotional level is depression. The discrepancy between my world and the world in the conscious level is illusion. Next, Subramanyas. Muruha. First, he goes round the world. as usual, when you go around the world, you will get into an intense rajas. In that extraordinary rajas, when you claim the victory, he comes back to see already won the, somebody has won the game. It is like, we have a very beautiful story about Bharata, whose name the whole Bharat is named. He suddenly felt he should conquer the whole world and conquers, reaches the peak of the Meru Hills, which is mythological basically in Hindu tradition, to establish his flag. When he goes there, suddenly he finds 10 million flags are there. Means before him, 10 million people have conquered the world. All their flags are there. He felt, oh God, where did I land? Then Brahma appears and says, oh my son, do not think you are the first one to conquer the world. Before you, millions of Bharatas have come. Millions of conquerors have come. All of them have conquered this world and claimed it is theirs, it is theirs, it is theirs. For this period, you are claiming it is yours, that's all. Then Bharata realizes, wow. That realization, click, makes him go for doing tapasya. And in that tapas, he becomes enlightened how to be in tune with the world and my world. The balancing of the world and my world happens. Please understand, if you don't balance the world and my world, even if you conquer, it will be suppression of the world. It will get back to you as tsunami. The materialistic civilization is conquering the world without balancing my world, which is leading to all ecological imbalances. All natural calamities. Here, just like Bharata, Muruga comes back after going around three times the world, sees Ganesha sitting contently, radiating, and that gives Muruga initiation. Click. So he goes to a private place, Palani, stays there and does tapas, becoming a sadhu. He becomes a sadhu, leaves everything, goes there and establishes himself in my world. When he is in tune with the world and my world, in the tapas in Palani, he becomes enlightened and starts radiating enlightenment to the world. Understand? The world and my world. You need to understand the whole story in right angle. Don't think he went and stood there in anger and how I came and sang some songs and then he went away back to Shivan. It is a cinematic version. Exactly this is what has happened. Subramanya, when he sees just the success in the world is not the ultimate, you need to balance, understand, tune with my world and the world, then conquer, then go beyond. Without in tune, any effort to conquer the world leads to great chaos in the world and my world. The restlessness in my world, natural calamities in the world. Extraordinary restlessness in my world reflects as natural calamities in the world. Understand? All the civilizations which is suffering with extraordinary attention to the world without balancing my world are suffering with too much of natural calamities. If you study, you will understand this truth. Natural calamity means the whole civilization is too much about the world. The balancing of my world is not happening. History should be in tune with mythology. Logic should be in tune with emotion. Facts should be in tune with truth. Binary should be in tune with zero. Understand? The binary logic, linear movement, should be in tune with circular movement. Logic based on zero. The Indian rishis were able to discover zero just because they were able to understand the secret connection between the world and my world. Only a person who can comprehend the deepest secrets of the world and my world can comprehend the power of zero. Zero cannot be mathematically understood. It is just a theory. If you want to experience zero, you need to make the world and my world in tune. Tuning my world into the world is the samyama you are expected to do, to fall in tune with the elements, fall in tune with the nature by Patanjali. I think this is a very sharp truth, very sharp concept. If you just understand this one story, Ganesha going round and Subramanya going round, you will see, are you going around the world or my world? Are you too much centered on my world or the world? Second, is your my world is really in tune with the world? Is your my world is complete right experience of the world, and the concept you carry about the world in my world, are they your beliefs or experiences? If Ganesha was just believing Shiva and Devi is his world, he wouldn't have won the game. Not only Shiva and Devi should be the world, Ganesha should be experiencing it. Not only the Guru should be the world, you should be experiencing Guru as the world. Only then going around the Guru or falling at the feet of the Guru again and again works on you. You win the game only if the Guru is the world and you experience him as the world in your world. Sometime Guru does some miracles to remind your logic he is the world, but it should become experience in your world. Like Ganesha, if you have experienced he is your world, just by going around him, you will have all the benefits of going around the world. You don't need to fall in tune with fire. If you just fall in tune with his firing, enough. You won the game. You will have the fruit of knowledge, enlightenment. If you have fallen in tune, means experience, your world is the world which is master, then instead of going through any of these great samyamas, sadhanas, you directly receive those benefits. That is why the Kundalini awakening, which happens for people who meditate for 12, 13 years, just like that happens in you. If you fall in tune with air element, prana, by meditating for years, the prana of the world, you start levitating. But when your trust, that feeling connection with the master happens, when he becomes the world of your world, you don't need to fall in tune with the prana of the whole cosmos. His prana is enough. You experience levitation. Understand? How to harvest all the seeds sown, grown, the crops created, not the crap, crops created by an incarnation. When you are around an incarnation, the only job in which you need to concentrate, aim, is realize the world and your world. I'll continue some of the deeper secrets in this sutra in the next satsangs. I bless you all. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, and share the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Never since we had a deep connection.